Ear has not heard, but God has. Please, I invite you to stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Beloved friends, in the waters of baptism, Virginia died with Christ and rose with him to newness of life. May she now share with Christ Christ's eternal glory. At baptism, she was signed with the cross, the sign of Christ's victory over death. May Christ now welcome her with these words: Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world.
Good afternoon and welcome to St. Michael's as we conduct the Mass of Christian burial and celebrate the life of Virginia Thomas. If you received a pamphlet on the way coming in, feel free to follow along with the Mass parts as you feel comfortable. Our opening song is On Eagle's Wings.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your daughter Virginia, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls are of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction. And their going forth from us, utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before mortals, indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God has tried and found them worthy of himself. A gold in the furnace, he has proved them, and as a sacrificial offering, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord. Thanks be.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God. Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth, for you are my God, and for you I will wait. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God. Good and upright is the Lord. He shows us the way. He guides the meek to justice. He teaches the humble to follow his ways. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God. Your way, O Lord, is kindness to those who are true. Your friendship is with those who love you. You reveal to them your word. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. My dear friends, as we have come together to celebrate the life of Virginia Thomas, on behalf of our parish family, I would like to extend our deepest condolences to the families of Thomas and Isabel on the death of Virginia. Also, I would like to recognize in our presence Bishop John Michael Botin, Romanian Byzantine Catholic of St. George's Cathedral here in Canton. Your Excellency, welcome. My dear friends, today we have come to celebrate the life of a special woman, I would like to reflect on the gospel, the Beatitude. If you go to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 7, verse 21, Jesus says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my heavenly Father." The question is, how do we live our life here on earth and then do the will of the Heavenly Father? This simple question has its answer today in our gospel, the Beatitudes, where Jesus gives his followers a roadmap to happy eternity. All the saints in heaven, from A to Z, they walked the hard and the narrow path of the Beatitude to arrive at the heavenly bliss where they are today. Because the Beatitudes propose to us a way of life, inviting us to identify with the poor, to identify with those who mourn, the meek, and to identify also with those who hunger and thirst for justice. The Beatitudes challenge us to be compassionate people, to be men and women who are pure in heart, and to become peacemakers in our dealings with one another, in our families, in our society. Even when such approach as exposes us to ridicule and persecution, none of the saints we know had it as their main aim in life to be wealthy, to acquire power, to gain popularity. Rather, they look forward to the eternal reward which God gives to his faithful ones at the end of this short earthly life by walking the way of the Beatitudes. Today, my dear friends, therefore, we have come to celebrate one of those saints who walked the way of the Beatitude, and her name is Virginia Thomas. You know how she walked it more than I do. From what just happened right now, when Stephanie came to read, the little baby cried, I want to read also for Virginia, because Virginia loved kids. As I was watching the picture, the slide you have, I saw her with kids. And from what the family said, sometimes she could even get down to be with them at their own eye level, seeing the innocence in them, loving kids. Those, Jesus said, leave them to come to me, because to such as these, the kingdom of heaven belongs to. It's just practical, because as we live, so as we die. The little girl said, no, I have to sing this song of praise for my beloved Virginia. Virginia walked the way of the Beatitude like the saints before her, with her faith in God. She was a religious person. She She was a prayerful woman. She walked the way of the Beatitudes by being a generous person. She cared for all. On Thursday, when I was invited to come, because she was on her last journey here on earth, by the time I got there, the whole family was there. The Thomases, all of them, they were there. Bishop can attest to this. Sometimes when we go to where people die, some of them die alone. People who have people all over, friends and family, they are left alone to die, but Virginia was not alone. The family was around her. So you gave her that support she needed. You bid her farewell because she loved and continued to love and lived in love with you all. As we live, so we die. She walked the way of the Beatitude by the way she treated her nieces, nephews, great nieces, and great nephews. I know you all will miss her phone calls. I know you will miss her sense of humor. I know you will miss her signature baking and cookings. But one thing you said here that really, I didn't come with it. Where is that insert on this? I was reading it before Mass. Thank you. I saw this. I read it a few minutes ago, and it captured what I'm trying to say. He said, God looked around his garden and found an empty place. He then looked down upon the earth and saw your tired face. He put his arms around you and lifted you to rest. God's garden must be beautiful. He always takes the best. He saw the road was getting rough and the hills were harder to climb. So he closed your weary eyelids and whispered, "Peace be thine." It broke our hearts to let you go, for parts of us went with you the day God called you home. This articulates your feelings, your sentiments, your love for your beloved Virginia. But one thing I want to tell us is, you know those things she was noted with, those great qualities you love about her, those are the legacies she's leaving behind. I know she loved to tell family stories, linking you all, how it began, where we were, this is it. This is our family story. Don't let that die with her. I know she used to bring you all together, make sure whoever goes home, "Hey, honey, are you home? Are you safe? What's going on?" Checking on one another, touching base with each other. Don't let that be buried with her today. Dear friends, we have nothing here on earth. We only have one another. We only have the love of each other. Whatever she worked for, material world, she may have acquired here on earth. Those beautiful clothes she used to get from whenever there were sales. Those wonderful things she used to get. None of them will be buried with her today.
You know what she goes with? Your love. And that makes her a millionaire in the presence of God. So let us love one another. Let us respect each other. Let us live the life of beatitude. It's no more about Virginia. It's about us. When my time comes, definitely my time will come. When your time comes, we lie like this. What will people say about us? Whatever people will say about us, we begin to write it right now.
I always tell the story about the day of birth. We say April 1929. There is dash. August 5, 2021. Do you know what God looks at? What we use that dash to do? What happened in between? Dash. What will your dash be and what we might be? This is the time we begin to write it. May we stand and pray. Petitions. My dear friends, let us make our prayers and petitions to Almighty God the Father.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis and for all the leaders of the world, that God grant them the wisdom and the fortitude to govern their people with love and justice, we pray to the Lord. That all people of the world learn to walk in the ways of justice, love, and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, the dying, that they be given the grace to offer their pain for the good of all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
For all those suffering from mental illness, that they may find happiness and be comforted by the promises of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
In thanksgiving for the many gifts, both spiritual and material, in Virginia's life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
For nieces and nephews who provide love and care, especially Loretta and Jean, who are always there when needed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
For the faithfully departed, especially Virginia's parents, Fada and Shadid, her sister Ani, her brother Lou, her nephew Little Lou, her brother-in-law Andy, and her cousins John, Mary, Margaret, and Tommy, we pray to the Lord.
Almighty God and Father, we have made our prayers and petitions known to you, and confident you have answered us through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. We now invite the family to bring up the gifts.
Channel of your peace, where there is hatred, let it be your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, ancestor, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand. To be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. Giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your daughter, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have heard us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your daughter, Virginia, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Beloved friends, at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, let us offer each other God's sign of peace. My dear friends, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Et bene.
et benedictus fructus ventris, ventris tu.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Virginia may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. At this juncture, I would like to invite Dev to come and share some words of remembrance.
Good afternoon. My wife Jean, my sons Justin and Stephen, and I were given the privilege of writing the eulogy for Virginia Ginny Thomas. And the challenge this afternoon, in no more than 5 minutes, is to try and share the impact this woman had on her family over the 92 plus years of her life. Perhaps a hospice auctioneer's rapid-fire voice is in order to accomplish such a feat, but we'll do our best. I personally loved Ginny very much. I cherished the times we had eating lunches together, scratching off lottery tickets, making Dairy Queen runs, and helping her in the house and outside, often while talking about family. I will miss her very much. And when we sent out a text asking family to share memories regarding Ginny, we received many, many warm and loved memories. The first memory Stephen mentioned was how he and Ginny used to do puzzles together. So puzzles are going to be the theme for this eulogy because they're a lot like life. At first, it's not always easy to make sense of them, but by the end, when it all comes together, you see the beautiful picture that was there all along. Putting together this eulogy was a lot like doing a puzzle. Trying to put together all of the memories was no easy task, but we hope when we're finished, all of you can see the beautiful picture that was Ginny's life. The first piece of the puzzle that almost always comes to mind when thinking about Ginny is her cooking. She had more cookbooks than Betty Crocker herself and was always open to sharing her favorite recipes with family and friends. Some of her famous dishes were the specialty breads and her classic orange jello dessert. She loved tending to her garden and sharing her grape leaves. She was always sure to overfeed like a true Lebanese woman. The second piece of the puzzle that Ginny will always be remembered for is her hard work and determination. She was the first of her siblings to bravely start school at St. Paul's in Canton, despite knowing very little English, paving the way for her younger siblings. She oftentimes worked morning till night at the grocery store with Sito Fada, and was never scared to do the closing shift at the Hall of Fame Fitness Center with her cousins, or to chase down a store robber with a meat cleaver. Not only was Ginny hardworking and determined, but she also enjoyed life and its adventures, which is the third piece of the puzzle. Memories of her childhood years of closing the store on a Sunday evening, then heading to the movie theater, watching movies with her siblings and cousins, or all of them traveling to Myers Lake Amusement Park. She enjoyed spending time with her close friends, Nellie and Esther. She traveled to faraway places such as Cuba and Hawaii, and rumor has it, her and Yvonne even visited a dude ranch on one of their trips. Can you imagine? Ginny never gave herself enough credit for her sense of humor, and many will remember her for her sharp wit. She loved to shop, and she also enjoyed playing the lottery for years and years, but never won big. The next piece of the puzzle, and arguably the piece that most defined Ginny, was her ability and desire to care for others. It's truly remarkable to think about how she cared for five generations of family members. She was a key source of support for her mother, living with her and caring for her for many years. She opened the door for anyone, always welcoming in her siblings, nieces, and nephews whenever they needed a meal or someone to visit with. In her retirement, she took care of Justin and Stephen, which was a major help to Jean and me while we worked. And Stephen promises that the stitches and broken leg were his own fault and not Ginny's. In her later years, she loved to spend time with her great-great nieces and nephew. Nothing put a smile on her face more than a child. But despite all those she cared for, none were more pampered than her dog Fritzy, who she cooked special meals for and spoiled with ice cream sandwiches. The fifth piece of this 500-piece puzzle, just kidding, this is the last piece, I promise you, and the piece that completes the puzzle, Ginny's faith. Ginny, like the rest of her family, had a special relationship with Mother Mary. She frequently prayed to St. Jude and St. Charbel, the patron saint of Lebanon. As a theology teacher, I especially appreciated this about Ginny, and I enjoyed reading several of the spiritual books she kept on her shelf. Lastly, we can only imagine the faith and humility it took for the caregiver to become the one receiving care. There are many who loved and cared for Ginny in her final years, but especially her nieces, Lori and Jean. We would also like to give special thanks to all those from Helping Hands who loved and cared for Ginny as well. Many of these people surrounded Ginny in her final days, and although Ginny never won big with the lottery or the publishing clearinghouse, she finally hit the jackpot, gaining eternal life with her Lord and with those who went before her. God bless you, Ginny. We'll miss you. Please pray for us.
Please may we stand. Dear friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Go forth, Christian soul, from this world in the name of God. Go forth, beautiful one. Fly away with the angels, with the angels. Christian soul from this world. In the name of God, go forth, go forth, beautiful one. Fly away to the Savior, fly away.
Lord, we commend the soul of our sister in the sight of this world. She is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sin she may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, in peace, let us take our sister to her final place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the holy martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people, light for the world to see. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church. Gather today. Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church. Gather today. Longing for food, many are hungry. Longing for water, many still thirst. Make us your bread, broken for others, shared until all are fed. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today. Longing for shelter, many are homeless. Longing for warmth, many are cold. Make us your building, sheltering others, walls made of living stone. Christ, be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light, shine in your church, gather today.